लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट द वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मार्केट्स। तो एज यू आर एबल टू सी देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मार्केट्स, वन इज मनी मार्केट एंड अनदर वन इज कैपिटल मार्केट। व्हाट इज मनी मार्केट? दैट मनी मार्केट इज रिलेटेड विद द शॉर्ट टर्म सिक्योरिटीज, मीन्स वेयर सिक्योरिटीज लेस देन 12 मंथ्स कैन बी रेज्ड, दैट इज अ मनी मार्केट। Later we will study about the capital market. Let us study in detail about the money market. Money market, that is for arrangement of short term funds, means where securities less than 12 months can be arranged. These securities are the close substitute for money. Close substitute for money means that it can be easily converted into the cash. Definitely, here the risk is low. When a business institution or when an investor invests the money for a short term period, so definitely it is lower risk. And these kind of securities are unsecured and no security is being put for such kind of financial assets. These are the short term debts for a company, for a business organization, because we are saying that it is for less than 12 months and highly liquid, anytime it can be converted into the cash. But such market is not having any physical location. Markets or the activities, securities traded in the money market can be converted into cash, or cash can be converted into the securities via telephonically or through the internet. In money market, the securities are being issued just to meet the temporary shortage of cash and other obligation. Or whenever a business organization or the saver is having the excess funds and it wants to earn some returns, so these are invested in the money market. The major participants who invest in the money market, or through whom the money market securities can be invested, these are Reserve Bank of India, commercial banks, non-banking finance companies, state governments, and large corporate houses and mutual funds. These are the main participants. Means these institutions, they issue the securities for less than 12 months to one and another. Means Reserve Bank, sometimes they lend to the non-banking finance companies, or non-banking finance companies, they lend to the state governments, or commercial banks, they lend to the large corporate houses as well as mutual funds. So here let us study about the money market instrument. The kind of instrument traded in the money market is treasury bill. What is treasury bill? It is basically an instrument of short-term borrowing. As it is a money market instrument, so this is definitely a short-term borrowing, less than 12 months. All the instruments we will study in the money market, these will be the short-term borrowings. By whom? That means Government of India. And these securities are generally issued by Reserve Bank of India. To whom? To the Government of India. Might be the central government, might be the state government. What is the purpose of lending the money to the central government? To meet the short-term requirements of the funds. So these bills are also known as the zero coupon bonds. And these are issued in the form of a promissory note. They are highly liquid, means can be converted into the cash, and have assured yield and negligible risk of default. Means either these are unsecured, even these are unsecured, even then the risk is zero, negligible risk of default. Means aisa nahi ki if the money is invested in the treasury bill then it would be converted into the bad debts. No, the treasury bills are issued in the form of promissory note. Promissory note, if you remember, that is a legal document where the borrower promises that I would make the payment, I promise to pay. Treasury bills are always issued at a price which is lower than the face value and repaid at par. Means the person, the institution who borrows, like we are saying that issued by Reserve Bank of India to the central government or on the behalf of central government, issued by Reserve Bank of India on the behalf of central government to government of India. Reserve Bank issue कर रहा है central government के behalf पे to the various government of India, might be Indian Railways है, might be statutory corporation की कोई है, then they will initially be given 96 rupees suppose, and when they are to repay the money, they are repaying at 100. Means these treasury bills are always issued at lower than face value and repaid at the par. The discount, the 4 rupee discount is generally known as discount. And it is the one of the other feature of the treasury bill is that minimum amount of treasury bill is multiple of 25,000. The next one is commercial paper. The commercial paper is, again I would say that these, because these are the instruments of money market, so these are unsecured short term kind of papers. And these are issued by the large and credit worthy companies to raise short term funds at the low rate of interest than the market rates. That large companies, they issue the commercial paper for the purpose of raising short term funds, and generally the rate of interest is lower than the market rate. The time period is such shorter that it is for, it may be for 15 days to 1 year. And issuance of commercial paper is an alternative to the bank borrowing. Means mujhe bank se loan lene ki bajaye, what I can do, I can get a commercial paper from the large and credit worthy companies. And definitely those companies will issue which are financially strong. Or these commercial paper are always also issued at discount and redeemed at par. And the companies, such companies, when the company will be is in need of the working capital, seasonal working capital, so these companies get the funds through the commercial paper. And the money can be used through the commercial paper is known as the bridge financing. So here is an example for the commercial papers. Suppose a company wants to finance its want to purchase a machinery, and for that purpose it needs a long term finance. And for raising the long-term finance in the capital, from the capital market, definitely a flotation cost will be involved. And that flotation cost may be in the form of issue of brokerage commission, printing of application and advertisements, etc. So to meet such kind of expenses, that funds are raised through the commercial papers, which is known as the bridge finance. Call money. So it is a short term finance again. short term finance because it is an instrument of money market. And generally, if you know that banks have to maintain a minimum cash balance, which is known as the cash reserve ratio. And Reserve Bank of India changes the cash reserve ratio from time to time. Time to time means that if it is if the ratio is somewhat different today, it may be somewhat different tomorrow. So call money is a method by which bank borrows from each other. Suppose if X bank is there and this X bank is having 10,000 as a minimum balance, and immediately Reserve Bank of India changes that limit that no, 10,000 nahi, that the minimum balance should be 15,000. The rest of the 5,000 X bank will get from the other bank, may get from the other bank, and in the form of loan. Aur us 5,000 per jab other bank interest charge karega, that is known as a call rate. Aur ye call rate is highly volatile, change hota rehta from even day to day and from hour to hour. So there is an inverse relationship between call rates and the other short-term money market instruments. If a call rate is rising, then the other sources of finance, that means commercial paper and certificate of deposits, become the cheaper. Means ek bank agar apni minimum amount ko maintain karne ke liye higher rate of interest per interest dene ke liye tayar nahi hai, तो वो अपने नीडेड फंड जो है वो किस सोर्स के थ्रू, सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ डिपॉजिट और कमर्शियल पेपर्स के थ्रू अरेंज कर सकता है. द नेक्स्ट वन इज सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ डिपॉजिट्स. अगेन दीज आर द अनसिक्योर्ड नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड जनरली द कंपनीज दे इश्यू इट इन द टाइम ऑफ टाइट लिक्विडिटी व्हेन द डिपॉजिट ग्रोथ ऑफ द बैंक इज स्लो बट द टाइम ऑफ credit is high. In this way, that money can be mobilized for the short period. The last one is commercial bill. It is a bill of exchange. It is just like a bill of exchange, which is required to finance the working capital requirement of the business. So, when the goods are sold on the credit, that you have studied in it in the form of bill of exchange. So, when the goods are sold on credit and buyer becomes liable to make payment on the specific date. So, some writing process is there and the seller, that is drawer, he draws the bill to the buyer and buyer accepts. And when the bill is accepted, it is known as a trade bill. Or when the trade bill is discounted from the bank, then it is known as the commercial bill. जब trade bill और एक bill of exchange bank से discount हो जाता है, तो it is known as a commercial bill. That's all for the day. Thank you.